Hello everyone, welcome to PRV Solution. So in this video lecture we will study an important topic, CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope. It is very important device which you will find in your lab, which is used for testing of the signals. Let us start our topic. Firstly, how a CRO looks like. It looks like the picture of the CRO is shown in the figure. It is two channel CRO, channel 1 and channel 2. Two channel means two signals can be displayed simultaneously on the screen. It has different knobs, time based generator, which is time per division scale, and two scales are also there for voltage per division for first channel and voltage per division for second channels. So, introduction. It is a versatile electronic instrument giving visual display of signals. So, it is used for visualizing the signals. Second, it is used for measurement of frequency, amplitude, phase, etc. Using Lesage's figure, we can measure frequency and phase also. Third is also used in determining the nature and characteristics of various components. It can also be used for finding the characteristics of various components, like diode characteristics you can find directly when you will connect a diode to its terminal. So, fourth point is has a high bandwidth range. So, it is very sensitive and accurate device, that is why it is used mostly. They are very fast XY plotters, means two dimensional plotters displaying an input signal versus another signal or versus time. So, it is used for display input signal with respect to another signal or with respect to time. The stylus. Stylus means point. The point of this point plotter is a luminous spot which moves over the display area in response to an input voltage. This luminous spot will move on the display area in response to input voltages. The luminous spot is produced by a beam of electrons striking a fluorescent screen. This luminous spot is produced by the beam of electrons which strikes on the fluorescent screen. The normal form of a CRO uses horizontal input voltage, which is an internally generated ramp voltage called time base. So, normally a CRO uses a horizontal input voltage. This horizontal input voltage is nothing, it is a ramp voltage, which is also known as time based voltage. The horizontal voltage moves the luminous spot periodically in a horizontal direction from left to right over the display area or screen. This horizontal voltage that is generated from the ramp voltage moves the spot in horizontal direction from left to right. Similarly, we have to move the spot from or vertically upward and downward according to input signals. This will cover by this point. The vertical input to the CRO is the voltage under investigation. So, the input signal which you want to display or visualize is applied to the vertical input of the CRO. The vertical input voltage moves the luminous spot up and down in accordance with the instantaneous value of the voltage. So, this vertical input voltage moves this signal in upward and downward direction according to instantaneous value of the voltage signal to be investigated. The luminous spot thus traces the waveform of the input voltage with respect to time. So, in this way it will visualize the input signal. When the input voltage repeats itself at a fast rate, the display on the screen appears stationary on the screen. So, when this input voltage is repeating at a fast rate, so then you will see that the luminous spot will produce stationary wave on the screen. थर्ड पॉइंट, द सी आर ओ दस प्रोवाइड अ मीन्स ऑफ विजुलाइजिंग द टाइम वेराइंग वोल्टेजेस। एज सच द सी आर ओ हैज़ बिकम अ यूनिवर्सल टूल इन ऑल काइंड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इन्वेस्टिगेशन। सो इट इज़ ए यूनिवर्सल टूल फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इन्वेस्टिगेशंस। दिस इज द ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द सी आर ओ। द इनपुट सिग्नल विच वी वॉन्ट टू विजुलाइज इज गिवन टू वर्टिकल एम्पलीफायर। दिस विल एम्पलीफाई द इनपुट सिग्नल। डिले लाइन विल प्रोड्यूस सम डिले बिफोर इट गोज टू द वर्टिकल डिफ्लेक्शन प्लेट्स। एंड फ्रॉम दिस वर्टिकल एम्पलीफायर वी हैव अनदर सिग्नल विच ट्रिगर्स द टाइम बेस्ड जनरेटर सर्किट विच प्रोड्यूसेज अ रैम्प वोल्टेज और स्वीप वोल्टेज विच इज एम्पलीफाइड बाय द हॉरिजॉन्टल एम्पलीफायर एंड देन इट विल गोज टू द हॉरिजॉन्टल डिफ्लेक्शन प्लेट्स विच मूव्स द सिग्नल फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट। हॉरिजॉन्टल डिफ्लेक्शन प्लेट मूव्स द सिग्नल दिस स्पॉट फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट एंड दिस वर्टिकल डिफ्लेक्शन प्लेट्स आर यूज टू डिफ्लेक्ट द सिग्नल इन अपवर्ड एंड डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन। दिस इज द ल्यूमिनस स्पॉट। दिस इज द फास्फोरस स्क्रीन ओवर विच बीम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन स्ट्राइक्स। So it consists of the following major subsystems. First is the display. The display, this is the display of the CRO. It can be LCD or CR2. It also has horizontal and vertical reference lines for measurement purpose. Cathode ray tube, it is the heart of the CRO. This cathode ray tube emits electrons that strikes the phosphor screen internally to provide a visual display of signal. It displays the quantity being measured. Vertical amplifier amplifies the signal waveform to be viewed. Delay line, it delays the signal for some time in the vertical section. Horizontal amplifier, this is used to amplify the sawtooth voltage or ramp voltage which is then applied to X plates or horizontal plates of the CRO. Sweep generator is also known as time based circuit. It produces the sawtooth voltage waveform for horizontal deflection of the electron beam. Trigger circuit produces trigger pulses to start horizontal sweep. So, this trigger circuit is used to produce the horizontal sweep voltages. It converts the incoming signal into trigger pulses so that the input signal and the sweep frequency can be synchronized. This input signal and this sweep frequency must be synchronized. It is synchronized by this trigger circuit. Then we have high and low voltages, which is present here. High voltage supply and low voltage supply. The low voltage means plus 300 to 400 volt and the high voltage means minus 1000 to minus 1500 volt. Now we will study CRT. It is the heart of the oscilloscope and is similar to the picture tube in a television set. Construction, the cross section view of the general purpose electrostatic deflection CRT is shown in the next slide. This is the electron gun assembly or cross section view of the CRT. It has four major components. Electron gun for producing a stream of electrons. Electron gun which is used to produce stream of electrons. Focusing and accelerating anode to produce narrow beam and sharply focused beam of electrons. These are three anodes which we will use for focusing and accelerating purpose. Horizontal and vertical deflecting plates for controlling the path of the beam. This is the horizontal or vertical plates which controls the path of the beam. An evacuated glass envelope with a phosphorescent screen which produces bright spot. So here we have a phosphorescent screen which produces bright spot when electrons strike on this phosphorescent screen. So, it consists of an indirectly heated cathode K, a control grid G. This is the control grid G. It is also known as intensity grid or intensity button in the CRO because it controls the beam current or intensity of the beam. A pre-accelerator anode A1, this is the pre-accelerator anode A1, focusing anode A2, and further we have another accelerating anode A3. Deflecting plates. Two sets of deflecting plates are used for deflecting the thin pencil like electron beam both in the vertical and horizontal directions. These are the horizontal and deflection plates which are used to deflect the beam in horizontal and vertically. So, first vertically deflection plates. These plates move the electron beam up and down the screen. The input signal is applied to these plates. So, vertical deflection plates move the beam up and down. Horizontal deflection plates move the beam from left to right or right to left. The first set marked Y nearer to the gun is for vertical deflection and X set is for horizontal deflection. You will find two buttons on the CRO, which is X button and Y button. Y button is used for vertical deflection and X button is used for horizontal deflection. When no potential is applied across the plates, beam passes between the both the sets of the plates undeflected, so produces a bright spot at the center of the screen. So when no potential is applied, you will find a spot at the center of the screen. Working. The electron gun generates the beam which moves down the tube and strikes the screen. The screen glows at a point of collision, producing a bright spot. This electron gun generates the beam which is moved up and down by the plates and produces a bright spot on the screen. When the beam is reflected by means of an electric or magnetic field, the spot moves accordingly and traces out a pattern. This spot which is present at the center can be moved by the electric and magnetic field produced by the deflecting plates. The electron gun assembly consists of the indirectly heated cathode with its heater, the control grid and the first and the second anodes. The control grid in the CRT is cylindrical with a small aperture in line with the cathode. Control grid is always cylindrical in nature. The electron emitted from the cathode emerge from this aperture as a slightly divergent beam, and the negative bias voltage applied to the grid controls the beam current. I have already discussed it in earlier slide. The intensity or brightness of the phosphorescent spot depends upon the beam current. So, this control grid bias knob is called or labeled as intensity button on the CRO. The diverging beam of electrons is converged and focused on the screen by two accelerating anodes which form an electronic lens. So, electronic lens is formed by two accelerating anodes. They will converge the beam that is produced by the electron gun. The combination of the first anode cylinder and the wider second anode cylinder produces an electric field. This electric field will focuses the electron beam on the screen. As a lens converges a diverging beam of light. So, that is why it is known as electronic lens. The electronic lens action is controlled by the focus control. This electronic lens is controlled by the focus control which is present on the as a button on the CRO. Since the electron beam is a stream of electrons, a positive field will divert it in one direction and a negative field will divert it in opposite direction. To move the beam in this way in the CRT, deflecting plates are mounted inside the tube which are horizontal and vertical deflecting plates. They are suitable deflecting and suitable deflecting voltages are applied to them for producing the signal. These plates are arranged in two pairs, H1 and H2. As shown in the figure, these are horizontal deflection plates, H1 and H2, vertical deflection plates, V1 and V2. And some leads are taken out for the external connection. The beam passes down the tube between the four plates. This beam will pass between these four plates. Now, we will discuss the working of the plate. that how these plates will affect the spot position. So when the plates are at zero voltage, the beam is midway between them and the spot is in the center of the screen. When the voltage at four plates are zero, then we will find the spot in the center of the screen. When H1 is made positive with respect to the cathode and all other plates are at zero voltage, means only this H1 is positive. This is in the left side of this tube. So it attracts the beam and spots moves horizontally to the left. So beam will move horizontally to the left, and when H2 is positive, then beam will move to the right. Similarly, when V1 is made positive, V1 is on upper side of this tube, then it will move the beam in upward direction. When V2 is positive, then this will move the beam in downward section. So in each of these deflections, the displacement of the beam and therefore the distance traveled by the spot is proportional to the applied voltage at the plates. So the movement between on the screen will depends upon the voltage applied at the plates. Suppose if a negative voltage is applied to any plate, then the beam will repelled rather than attracted and the deflection will be in opposite direction. For example, if V1 is made negative, suppose V1 is made negative, V1 is on the upper side, then it will repel the beam, then beam will move downward. So when V1 is negative, then beam will move downward. Made negative, then the beam will deflected vertically downward. So when a rapidly pulsating or AC voltage is applied to the deflecting plate, so if we will apply AC voltage to deflecting plates, the beam is moved back and forth so rapidly that the spot traces a line. This spot will trace a line. When a positive pulsating voltage is applied to H1 or negative pulsating to H2, the spot traces a horizontal line from the center to the left. Similarly, when a positive pulsating voltage is applied to H2 or negative to H1, the spot traces a horizontal line from center to the right. So when the pulsating voltage is applied to V1, we will get a vertically line from center upwards, and when applied to V2, we will get a line from center to the downward. So hence a horizontal line is traced when an AC voltage is applied either horizontal plates. Similarly, we can get a vertical line is traced when an AC voltage is applied to the vertical plates. So there is a question, what happens to the beam voltage when the voltage is applied simultaneously to both vertically and horizontal plates? When we will apply pulsating voltage to both the plates simultaneously. Now the answer is, when the voltage is applied to the vertical and horizontal plates simultaneously, the deflection of the beam is proportional to the resultant of the two voltage. Now the deflection is the resultant of the two voltage, and the position of the beam is in between the horizontal and vertical axis of the screen. So in this way, the beam will displayed as a signal which is a resultant of voltage applied at a horizontal and vertical plates. So now the applications in radio work. First application is to trace and measure a signal throughout the RF radio frequency, intermediate frequency and audio frequency channels of the radio and television receivers. It provides the only effective way of adjusting FM receivers, broadband high frequency RF amplifiers and automatic frequency control circuits. To test AF circuits for different types of distortions and other spurious oscillations. Fourth application is to give visual display of wave shapes such as sine wave, square wave, and there are many different combination when we will apply it from the function generator. To trace transistor curves, to visually show the composite synchronized TV signals, and to display the response of tuned circuits. In scientific and engineering applications, it also has applications, measurement of AC and DC voltages, finding BH curves for hysteresis loop, for engine pressure analysis, for study of stress, strain, torque, acceleration, etc. Frequency and phase discrimination by Lissajous figure. Radiation patterns can also be obtained by using CRO. Amplifier gain, modulation percentage can also be calculated. Complex waveform as a short circuit for Fourier analysis. Standing waves in transmission lines, etc. So these are the different applications of the CRO. So it is very versatile device used for testing of the signals or visualizing the signals. Thanks for watching.